بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله معز الإسلام بنصره ومذل الشرك بقهره ومصرف الأمور بأمره ومديم النعم بشكره، جعل الأيام دولاً بعدله والعاقبة للمتقين بفضله، ومن آياته أن تقوم السماء والأرض بأمره، أظهر دينه على الدين كله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة أدخرها ليوم يعرض فيه عمل العبد على ربه، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسل بالهدى ليعلو هداه على هدى غيره، صلى الله ربنا عليه ثم سلم لا سيما أبا بكر الذي سمت به إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله، وعمر الذي وافق حكمه حكم لولا كتاب من الله، وشهيد الدار الذي جاء مدحه لدى لقد تاب الله، وعليا الذي أحبه الله ونزل فيه إنما نطعمكم لوجه الله، وعلى التابعين ومن تبعهم ما أمت الوفود بيت الله ولهجت الألسن بلا إله إلا الله. أما بعد، فيا عدة الإسلام وذخره وكنزه وفخره، ظله الوارث وغمامه الواكف، شامة اليمين وشامة الجبين وطول اليمين، حياكم الرحمن خير تحية، أرجو العقيدة من شذاها يعبق وتكاد تنطق لو أطاع المنطق. فالسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، ما حنت النيب إلى الفصال وتحلل المحبون بذكر أزمنة الوصال، سلام في ثناياه حبور وسامعه من الأحزان ناجي، كشهد في زلال بل كجسم سرت في جسم معتدل المزاج. يا مسلمون عموما ويا مسلمي أمريكا خصوصا، وعمار المنهال على وجه أخص، لأنتم الأهلون سيد عمى اللسو وأرقة زهلول وعرفاء جيأل، أنتم الأهلون لا مستودع السر ذائع لديهم ولا الجاني بما جر يخذل، لا فل منكم غرب ولا روع لكم سرب، أدام إله العالمين لكم عافية وصيَّر دور العدا عافية، وحباكم الرتب العظام السامية، وبارك المولى في ذهابكم وإيابكم، دمتم مدى الأيام في عافية ودار من يشنى هداكم عافية. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون، واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله. The first thing we usually comments and the first statement on the member of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the praise of Almighty subhanahu jalla jalaluh wa taqaddasat nu'utuh. Without a shred of doubt, we testify the seal of prophets and the last messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu wasallam alayhi, upon his families, those who came after, and the Sahaba who carried the message of Islam all the way to the end of their lives till we receive the message, and those who embrace the message to the last day. Muslims of today, before we open today's chapter, the first thing I will do after that praise of Allah is to pray and implore the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon and for those who died last week in Haram, aiming to visit the house of Allah during the Hajj, aiming to make tawaf amid Hajj. However, the Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Mashi'ah of Allah, like Imam al-Tahawi said, غَلَبَتْ مَشِيئَتُهُ الْمَشِيئَاتِ كُلَّهَا. The Mashi'ah of Allah, the will of Allah, and whatever He subhanahu wa ta'ala had planned, no one can alter His plan. No one can change the plans of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They went for Hajj, that was the end. They went for Umrah, that was the last moment of their lives. So I pray that the talbiyah that they went for them to be revivified on the day of Qiyamah, for them to be resurrected on the day of Qiyamah with their talbiyah, لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. And the beauty of Islam rises from here. Though Muslims, some witnessed their death, but that did not change their intention. Why? Because this is the place, or that was the moment that Muslim, as a Muslim, there is no place in this life or this world that you will even pray for Allah to take your lives like that spot. So Muslims carried on their tawaf, people praying. After that, they continued with your own salah, and that recalled the incident that took place during the time that Umar ibn al-Khattab was assassinated. As he was stabbed, Muslims did not stop praying. Muslims did not say, well, let's take him or call 911. Why? Because the 911 that a Muslim has in his chest, in his heart, is that which governs his life. So if someone is dead, the one whom he was worshipping is still alive. So they did not stop their prayers, they did not stop their rituals, they did not stop their Umrah, they did not stop aiming Hajj, just like Sahaba at the time of Umar did not stop. So I pray, supplicate, and call upon the ever compelling Creator subhanahu jalla jalalu to shower His mercy on those who lost or died last week, and also with Sabr and Sulwan to envelop the families of those who ended up dying in Arabian Peninsula. Allahumma ameen. Last week, the legacy of sacrifice stood up on this minbar. Today, the best days in our lives is visiting. Behind it, the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In front of it, the Quran of Allah. On the right, Sahaba with their statements, and on the left, those who oppose. Their statement is not to be welcomed, and their statements not to be accepted and not to be embraced. The best 10 days are the days that you, i.e. Muslims, are living in right now. In authentic hadith, Prophet ﷺ authentically was reported to have said, ما من أيام أن عمل الصالح فيهن أحب إلى الله من عشر ذي الحجة. قيل يا رسول الله ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله؟ قال ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله ولم يرجع من ذلك بشيء. The best days that a slave that bondmen, that servants of Allah could be closer to Allah at the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Impossible for someone to be better than you. If you, as a Muslim, male or female, as a Muslim, young or old, as a Muslim, lettered or unlettered, as a Muslim, wise or not, as a Muslim, young or old, as a Muslim, wealthy or not, the best days in your life are these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Better than the last 10 days of Ramadan, arguably. Better than the last 10 days of Ramadan. So these days, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, do not play with them. And according to Abdullah ibn Abbas, in Tafsir of Al-Awfi, on the authority of Tal'a, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, as they gleaned this hadith from him, Abdullah ibn Abbas said, what Almighty Subhanahu Jalla Jalalu wa Amma Nawalu said in Surah Al-Fajr, Wal-Fajri, Wal-Layalin Ashr, that the 10 nights that Almighty Subhanahu wa Ta'ala did swear by in Surah Al-Fajr are the nights of Dhul Hijjah. This Dhul Hijjah that you are in. And to be closer to Allah, the best act of worship is dhikr, remembrance of Allah. And in the book of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbalin, radiallahu anhu, in the best musnad in the world, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal mentioned, again on the authority of Abdullah ibn Abbas, the hadith is also in the book of Imam Abi Dawood, in Jami' of Imam Tirmidhi, that Abdullah ibn Abbas said from Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the best dhikr in the first 10 days of Ramadan, afwan, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, at-takbiru wa-tahleelu wa-tahmeed. At-takbir in Arabic, when they say halala fulan, ay qala la ilaha illallah. Amid Allah fulan, ay qala alhamdulillah. Sabbaha fulanunillah, ay qala subhanallah. وحسب لفلان أي قال حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل وحوقل فلان أي قال لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. So حوقل is when you say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. هللا is when you said لا إله إلا الله. حمدلا is when you say الحمد لله. So this form of الحمد or التكبير or التهميد or التحليل or التسبيح are the best format of a dhikr in the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu anhuma and Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu wa an baqiyati as-sahabati alayhim min Allah ridwan. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be blessed, or also to bless all of them, or for Allah to bless all and for us to be blessed, the best format of dhikr, la ilaha illallah, سبحان الله حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل الحمد لله لا إله إلا الله سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم. To an extent, these two sahaba, Abu Huraira, Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنهم, they used to go. I say رضي الله عنهم, though they are two, but I also inserted Umar for him to be the third, because that was the father of Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu anil jami'. They used to go outside reminding people with dhikr, la ilaha illallah, for people to repeat, subhanallah, for people to hear them, subhanallah, for them to remind, for them to say Allahu Akbar in their houses, in their own homes, at the sunnah of Rasulullah. But they want to obtain extra reward, they used to go outside to remind people. So as Muslim of today, you have group of Muslims somewhere sitting, especially in these days that are known as Ayyam Ma'lumat, the well-known days in Quran of Allah, in chapter 22 in Surah Al-Hajj, from 26 all the way to the 27th and 28th verses, Almighty said, we bless you in these days of Dhul Hijjah for you to remember us, for you to magnify us, and for you to make a lot and a lot of adhkar. So for a person to be blessed, for someone to receive this immense reward and this unprecedented format of al-maghfirah, yet you play in these 10 days, that means you are a loser. That if I play with them days, I will be a loser. But a quintessential, successful individual is he or she who assiduously praises Allah and continuously remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So with your dhikr, with your tahmid, with your tahleel, with your tahmid, in the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, remind your family, remind your students, remind your co-workers, remind your closest ones, remind your comrades, remind your closest families. Let them make a lot and a lot of dhikr, especially in these first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. وَالْبُدْنَ جَعَلْنَاهَا لَكُمْ مِنْ شَعَائِرِ اللَّهِ لَكُمْ فِيهَا خَيْرٌ فَاذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهَا صَوَافَّ فَإِذَا وَجَبَتْ جُنُوبُهَا فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا وَأَطْعِمُوا الْقَانِعَ وَالْمُعْتَرَّ كَذَلِكَ سَخَّرْنَاهَا لَكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. And Almighty, before this, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ عَلَى مَاذَا مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ. Almighty said, we've blessed you Muslims and those who want to embrace that system of life in the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah for you to remember us in dhikr, for you to make enough dhikr for your own benefit. So thanks in the sight of Allah, burden the days of Christmas, burden the days of Easter Sunday, burden the days of whatever Halloween, whatever we celebrate. And it's unfortunate that you see Muslims, we're supposed to be asking, what can I do to obtain Allah's pleasure? What is upon me as a Muslim to do in order for me to be closer to Allah? But we don't ask this. But I bet you when Christmas comes, can we exchange gifts? If we don't, when a non-Muslim gives me a gift, shall I take it or not? So a lot and bunch of questions all over, but when it comes to that which belongs to us, no questions at all. And in the statement of Abdullah ibn Umar, radiallahu anhuma, he said, مَا أَحْيَوُ النَّاسُ بِدَعَةً إِلَّا أَمَاتُ بِهَا سُنَّةً. Whenever you see people engaging themselves in innovations, you will see that when it comes to sunnah, they don't practice. When it comes to the sunnah of Rasulullah, when it comes to the way of Nabiullah, when it comes to the hadith of Khayr al-Ibad, when it comes to the way of the seal of all prophets and messengers, we don't ask questions, but let something come from the none. Can we do this? Can we do that? Why? No, because my children are asking me. Why? Because my family are asking. That is because if you do not occupy their minds with sunnah, bid'ah will take place to their minds. If you don't remind yourself with the hadith, somebody else will interpolate something in their system of life. So to Muslims, remember, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the first 10 days, the best acts of worship, one, dhikr. Two, fasting on the day of Arafah. Three, slurring on the day of Eid. When will Arafah be this year? On Wednesday. So on Wednesday, bi-idhnillah, fasting just the day of Arafah, a single day. To Allah, 2 years. Two, not one, two. Years of your shortcomings, sins, blasphemous acts, unpleasant conduct that you've compiled in your own sadaqa box of dhunub, Arafah will come and wipe. Arafah will come and efface. Arafah will come and take them away. Arafah will come to eradicate. Arafah will come to wipe. So do not play. Try your best. Remind your families. Even the children, let them use to fasting on the day of Arafah, the day of Ashura, Mondays and Thursdays. These are the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. But when you slaughter on the day of Eid, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do not slaughter except musinna. What is musinna? Musinna is an animal that Prophet ﷺ designated for ut'iyah, that do not slaughter except
Musinna. Musinna in camel is the animal, meaning the camel that had completed 5 years. Musinna in cows, 2. Musinna in sheep, 1. Prophet ﷺ said, "Illa an ya'sura alaykum, fatadbahu jada'atan min al-da'n." So do not slaughter on the day of Eid, except Musinna. So when you go, 4, Prophet ﷺ said, do not even choose them for Udhiyah, because if you do, Allah will not accept your Udhiyah. 1, the one-eyed animal. The animal with one eye, you can slaughter on the day of Eid. If you do, no reward whatsoever will be established for you. 2, you cannot slaughter the animal that is completely sick. The bones are crashing. No meat, nothing, no flesh at all. Say, this is my Udhiyah against the rule of Udhiyah. And Prophet ﷺ said, the lame animal likewise. And when you go, Prophet ﷺ said, the best amount that you put in, the best reward for you. And on the day of Eid al-Adha, the day of An-Nahr, when you put your own animal to slaughter on the day of Eid, Prophet ﷺ said, when you slaughter before you see the blood, your reward will be established before Allah. When you slaughter the animal, how long does it take for you to see the blood? 2 seconds? No. Less than that, the blood will be on the floor. But Prophet said, even when you slaughter before you as a slave, see the blood, your ajr is with Allah. Your reward with Allah. And whatever you do, you see before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Prophet ﷺ said, on the day of Qiyamah, you will see your animal coming to Allah with the horn, with the color, and the same animal that you slaughtered here in dunya is what you will see before Allah on the day of Qiyamah. So do you want to see very old animal before Allah? Do you want to see a very sick animal before Allah? No. So Muslims, لا تذبحوا إلا مسنة إلا أن يعصر عليكم فتذبحوا جذعة من الضأن والبدن جعلناها لكم من شعائر الله لكم فيها خير فاذكروا اسم الله عليها صواف. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العلي الجليل لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله. فجر الماء من الجلمود وأخرج الثمر من يابس العود وهو الكريم الودود. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ذو العرش المجيد فعال لما يريد. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صاحب لواء الحمد يوم العرض على الله. عليه الصلاة والسلام ما أمت الزوار بيت الله ثم أما بعد. To Muslims, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, what you do is what you will receive from Allah. To Allah, there's no such a thing as I'm special. To Allah, it's not such a thing that I've done enough for Allah. To Allah, your knowledge doesn't matter if your actions are not being supported. To Allah, your wealth will not save you from His chastisement on the day of Deen. So when it comes to worship, everybody must chase to the best. I'm saying this because oftentimes you see us when an ultimate opportunity is given, we don't take the benefit of it. A man came to Prophet ﷺ praying behind. After the salah, he said, Ya Rasulallah, O Messenger of Allah. I have noticed that whenever you pray in your dhikr, you say some dua and some adhkar, just like Mu'adh, but I don't really understand what you're saying in your dua. What you are saying, I don't understand, Ya Rasulullah. And the same thing, whenever Mu'adh leads us in prayer, that's the form of his dhikr. Moving his lips, but we don't understand. The same way you move in your lips, Ya Rasulullah, but we don't understand. Is there something special that you do after the salah that takes you closer to Allah? Prophet Sallallahu said, what Mu'adh and I are doing is nothing special. The same Jannah that you Muslims are asking for, the same Jannah that you, my companions, are asking for, that's the same Jannah that I'm also praying to receive on the day of Qiyamah. So Prophet Sallallahu, though his previous sins are forgiven, yet whatever takes him closer to Allah is what he engages himself in. So don't sit and say, well, I'm used to doing this, that's enough for me. And one day of Laylatul Qadr, it's like 82 years, so it's enough for me. And it's even better than 82 years, that's enough for me. No, Prophet Sallallahu, when it comes to these days of the Hijjah, dhikr after dhikr, awrad, adhkar, tuqus, at-tamalluq, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a Muslim, don't play with your dhikr. As a Muslim, don't avoid dhikr. As a Muslim, remind others. Just like some Muslims, they don't even feel ashamed to say Merry Christmas, but when you ask them, say dhikr for people to remember, or for people to say dhikr after you, say, well, I can't do that. We in front of non-Muslim, that's like, I can't do it. But a Muslim will not feel ashamed to say Merry Christmas or Happy New Year or Happy Birthday or whatever people celebrating out there, people saying out loudly, but a Muslim will also have a share in it. But when it comes to dhikr, no, I don't want them to look down on me. I don't want them to see that, to say, you know, Muslim always shouting, always, no, this is dhikr. So remind yourself, remind your family, remind your children, remind your students, this deen, as said last week, is through sacrifice. You have to sacrifice to receive. Without pain, nothing will be gained. So when you want good for yourself, whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you an opportunity, take it, because that's for you. And in an adage that is obtained from Chinese people, they say, well, it's in Chinese, I can't quote Chinese, so the meaning is what I will delineate right now. In Chinese adage, the following is the proverb: the more you sweat in peace, the less you bleed in war. Meaning, if you want to succeed tomorrow, you have to start it today. If you want to achieve success for yourself tomorrow, you have to struggle today. النعيم لا يدرك بالنعيم والدعة لا تدرك بالدعة ولا ينال الخبز حتى يسيل العرق ويعظم الجهد والنصب والأرق والسم أحيانا يعمل عمل الترياق ودون الشهد إبر النحل ومن رام اللآلئ زج بنفسه البحر واللآلئ تحطم لترفع في التاج والنحر وما العز إلا تحت ثوب الكد نعيم الأشواق بعد ذوق مر الأخطار في القفار بقدر العنى تنال المنى ما المجد ذخر في أقوال لصاحبه لا يدرك المجد إلا كل فعال كل له غرض يسعى ليدركه والحر يجعل إدراك العلا غرضا Whatever you want to achieve something, you have to make a move. Contentment is just an antonym of, you know, struggles. So you have to struggle in order for you to be content with whatever you will be given later on. So sacrifice is the way. Sometimes you don't want to do it, but this is what Allah asks. So to succeed tomorrow, you make the move today. By comparing yourself, we Muslims, we pray to be like those Sahaba who had died before us. We Muslims, oh Allah, unite us with the predecessors of this Ummah. Oh Allah, we Muslims, so we pray for us to be with Prophet ﷺ on the day of Qiyamah. ما كل برق لاح في الجو منطره وما كل قطر لو تأملت وابله وما كل من رام العلا أدرك العلا وما كل من يعرج سروج بفارسي It's not by claim you achieve or when the cloud changes that means it's about to rain or when you perish in the water you're coming out with jewels No you have to make sure determination and prognostication takes place before you even what make your move to success So struggle today To receive whatever you want from Allah tomorrow. So Muslims of the day, remember the sacrifice of our predecessors. Remember to follow their steps. But you want to sit down and just do whatever you want comfortably. And at the end, you be like them? Impossible. Here is Prophet ﷺ himself. Alayhi salatu wasalam, on the day of Eid al-Adha, they brought to him 63 badana, 63 camels for him to slaughter. He did not say, well, I'm the prophet. Why should I tie myself up? Why should I struggle with all 63? No, he started until one, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, fatigue penetrated his system. He called upon Ali to complete the rest. وَهُوَ سَيِّدُ وَلَدِ آدَمَ نَبِيُّ الْأُمَّةِ سَيِّدُ وَلَدِ آدَمَ إِسْمٌ حُرُوفُ الْمَعَالِي فِيهِ وَاضِعَةٌ وَكُلُّ عَالٍ سِوَاكُ حَرْفُ إِدْغَامِ تَرُوحُ بِرَأْيِهِ الظَّلْمَاءُ صُبْحًا وَيُسْتَسْقَى بِحِكْمَتِهِ الْغَمَامُ وَيُسْتَسْقَى بِحِكْمَتِهِ الْغَمَامُ حِكْمَةٌ فَيَّاضَةٌ عَبْقَرِيَّةٌ نَادِرَةٌ لَهُ رُتْبَةٌ مَا نَالَهَا الدَّيْرُ غَيْرُهُ تَسَامَتْ بِهِ فَوْقَ السُّهَى وَالْفَرْقَدِ So this is Prophet of Allah that when he sits, even clouds descends to ask for his own what? Opinion and guidance. So this is the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the first 10 days of the Hijjah on the day of Eid, not sitting one place to let the Sahaba do the rest. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam making the move. So as Muslims of today, don't sit and say, I've done enough. Don't sit and say, well, I'm the Imam. Don't sit and say, well, I'm the Sheikh. Don't sit and say, I'm the teacher. Don't sit and say, I'm the best. The best to Allah is the one who struggles to be closer to Allah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيِّ الْوَسِيلَةَ وَجَاهِدُوا فِي سَبِيلِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ عُمَرْ ابْنُ الْخَطَّابِ رضي الله عنه وأرضاه in the Medina of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم a man came to him, group of Muslims from Iraq visited Amir al-Mu'mineen when he became Khalifa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Umar became Khalifa, the Wafd of Iraq entered Medina and their leader was Ahnaf. So upon their entry, Umar called Ahnaf, saying, Ya Ahnaf, A'in Amir al-Mu'mineen, come and help Amir al-Mu'mineen. Why? Because when they brought to him Ibla Sadaqah, some Sadaqah for Muslims, out of Ibil camels, they saw Umar ibn al-Khattab by himself preparing them for Muslims with animals and Muslims are standing. So when those group of Iraq arrived, Ahnaf was their leader. Ahnaf, come and help Amir al-Mu'mineen. One of them said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, Alam tu'ayyin abdam min abidika yahna'u ank? Amir al-Mu'mineen, You are the Amir, you the Khalifa, you are Umar. Jannah is established. Prophet had given you that glad tidings. Why will you be struggling? You have slaves and even those captives, why don't you appoint them to prepare the camels for Muslims? He said, أَوَهُنَاكَ أَوَثَمَّ عَبْدٌ أَعْبَدَ لِلَّهِ مِنْ عُمَرَ وَأَحْنَفَ. What do you think, Umar? What do you think of Umar? What do you think of Ahnaf? Ahnaf and Umar both are slaves. أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ مَنْ وَلِيَ أَمْرًا مِّنْ أُمُورِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَانَ بِمَنْزِلَةِ الْعَبْدِ مِنَ السَّيِّدِ. Don't you know that when a person becomes a leader, alternatively, he turns to be the slave? He turns to be like a slave? He has to serve them? He has to give them service? That was Umar. He wasn't a leader, just going booking 400 hotels here, more than 400 Mercedes. No, to them it's movement for Allah. To them it's ibadah for Allah. To them they were slaves for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here is Ahnaf going to Amir al-Mu'minin saying, what do you want me to do? For me to follow your own footsteps. And both became slaves of Allah in their conduct, in their actions, not only verbal, not only verbally saying, we are slaves of Allah, but they do not put that into action. And I inform you, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, when they said to him, oh Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, people now saying you the fifth Khalifa, you the fifth Khalifa after Ali ibn Abi Talib. Do you want us to bury you next to Prophet ﷺ and his two companions? Umar ibn Abdul Aziz started weeping and crying, saying to them, Wallahi, لأن ألقى الله بكل ذنب سوى الشرك أحب إلي من أن أرى نفسي أهلا لتلكم المنزلة والعاقبة للمتقين. For me to think that I qualify to be next to Prophet ﷺ and his two companions, Umar and Abu Bakr, it's better for me to meet Allah with sins other than shirk than for me to think that I qualify to be next to them. Why? Because my deeds will never even take me closer to those guys, Umar and Abu Bakr. But come on and see the Muslims of today. Because he has the circle of knowledge, or he has some, you tell him, you the best? Well, I graduated from Saudi for 4 years, Yemen 3 years, Egypt I get my Arabic course for 10 years, so I'm the one. No, those Sahabas were not like that. To them, it's action. To them, it's movement for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to Muslims of today, through sacrifice, you will see yourself making dhikr. But if you don't sacrifice your time, you don't donate your time, you don't donate yourself for Allah, you will see the 10 days will finish and end, and yet you behind without joining the bus of believers. So to all of us, recall that those individuals, they stood up for their own deen through sacrifice. And when it comes to the justice of Allah, Allah doesn't care about your faith when you sit down lackadaisically. No, Allah only helps when you move. Allah helps when he sees you moving for his deen. And in this dunya, when you do the work, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will support you, whether Muslim or non-Muslim. When it comes to dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't look, say you have extra iman, so we give you everything. No, it's through actions, it's through sacrifice. America did not stand up without sacrifice. Though those who became the founding fathers of America, they struggled from the beginning. From Washington, from Thomas Paine, from Thomas Jefferson, from Ivan, all of them struggled because of peace. And Allah gave them their dunya, and they did not die until some of them were known to be the founding fathers of the country. It's through sacrifice. And it's amazing that you see Muslims outside America trying to imitate or emulate America, and no sacrifice. Sit in one place. Why are you sitting? Well, we are believers, we believe in Allah, inshallah, mashallah, alhamdulillah. Abdullah ibn Abbas, and from him, Hassan al-Basri. Don't sit and say, mashallah, thinking Allah will do the rest for you. No, you have to move because Prophet had moved. You have to move because predecessor had moved. Without that, no success for us in dunya, no success for us in akhirah. So remember the durus of sacrifice. Remember the best 10 days of your life, and also recall, whatever you do now, is double and double before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So finally, what we will conclude with today is to remind ourselves the day of Eid, Al-Adha, bi-idhnillahi tabaraka fi ula. And on the day of Eid, or the day of Eid will be Thursday, and the day before will be our Arafah day. So Arafah day, I was informed before coming today by one of the brothers, Brother Sayyid, that she will have iftar on the day of Arafah. So you come here after Maghrib, prayed Maghrib, there will be some iftar. And then he said, your support is needed to prepare the iftar for Muslims. And do not forget your udhiyah, if possible. And also whenever chance is given, like this chance that we received from Allah, as a Muslim, you have to opt to receive it. And also when Islam comes to you with something that you think will benefit you, don't bring this preconditioning in your mind and say, well, this is not how I knew it, I'm not going to do it this way. Why? Because in my country it's unlike this, in my place we did not use. No, so long as it's the sunnah of Prophet, that is the way to go. So long as it's from his teachings, this is the way to go. Why? Because Hudahu is the best Huda. The guidance that comes from him is the final guidance. You cannot find guidance better than that of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So take whatever you did in the first 10 days of the Hijjah, implore that in your lives, the life of your families, the life of your children, the life of whosoever you think is dearer to you, so that the reward will be also obtained for you. And tonight, bi-idhnillahi tabaraka fi ula, we will continue with this lesson. Whatever is needed from a Muslim when it comes to the last or the first 10 days of the Hijjah, remember your brothers in dua, brothers in Syria, do not forget them in your dua. And especially in these days that you're fasting, don't forget your brother in Afghan, your brothers in Egypt, and those in Somalia, in Nigeria, in Mali, people struggling. We make dua when we pray, when we fast, when we make dua, when we make sujood, when we make ruku', when we raise our hands to Allah in dua, do not forget them in your own dua. Remember them in your dua, make dua for them, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ease their lives for them, and make dua for your brothers and sisters, those who are still on the way, trying to escape from their lands. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make things easy on all of them, and we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our ibadah. And remember finally that when it comes to the day of Arafah, when you fast on the day of Arafah, Iblis, Shaitan says, oh Allah, look at me. Throughout the year, I misguided them. Throughout the year, I called them to indecencies. Throughout the year, I called them to sins. And now, on the day of Arafah, for a single day, they're fasting for Allah. They are doing ibadah for Allah. And Allah will forgive them 2 years. 2 years past and present. Almighty will forgive. Do you know what Shaitan will say? أُضِلُّكُمْ طُولَ الْعَامِ وَيَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ. Throughout the year, I misguided them, and today Allah is forgiving them. وَاللَّهِ لَأُضِلَّنَّهُمْ مَا دَامَتْ أَرْوَاحُهُمْ فِي أَبْدَانِهِمْ. I will never give up. I will pursue those individuals, meaning Muslims, and I will misguide you so long as you still breathing as a Muslim. I will never let you go by and pass by me. I will follow you closely to make sure you avoid the way of Allah. You avoid the sunnah of Rasulullah. You avoid your own deen, and you see your deen as backwards, and whatever is in the modern world is what you're supposed to go for. Shaitan said, I will be behind you till you give up. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his own rahmah, like Imam al-Tabarani mentioned in his book, Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to him saying, وَلَأَغْفِرَنَّهُمْ أَغْفِرَنَّ لَهُمْ مَا دَامُوا يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِي. And so long as my slaves call upon me, I will also forgive them. So just misguide them throughout. When they call me, I will forgive. So don't play with your forgiveness and don't play with your istighfar. I ask Allah to accept our istighfar. Allahumma ayyidna bil haqqi wa ayyid al haqqa bina. Ustur awratina, amin rawatina. Balighna mimma yurdika amalana. Ikhtim bil baqiyat as-salihati amalana. Allahumma inna nas'aluka hubbak wa hubba man yuhibbuk wa hubba kulli amalin yuqarribuna ila hubbik. Allahumma inna nas'aluka an tansura al-islam wa tu'izza al-muslimin. Allahumma a'li bi fadlika kalimatay al-haqqi wad-din. Allahumma اجعلنا من الفائزين. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تجعلنا من الفائزين. قد انقطع اللهم من غيرك الرجاء، فأدركنا أي رباه وارحم وأنعمه، وأشربنا أي رباه في القلب حبما، تحب وكره كل غي ومأثمه. ونسألك اللهم منك إعاذة من الحور بعد الكور والبون كالعمي، وأوزعنا أي رباه أن نشكر التي علينا بها أنعمت والفضل أتممه. لنا من إذا خيبت رب استجب دعاء وبالصالحات يا رب تممه. وها أنا ذا أطوي ما نشرت بساطه، وأستغفر الله العلي الجليل لزلتي.